Welcome to another Power BI tutorial. Today, at the request of one of our viewers, we will create a dashboard based on dummy brokerage data. We have been provided with the columns. We have generated random data in those columns to create a data set. We will use this data set to create the dashboard you are currently viewing. Let's have a look at our data. We have about 7 clients around the world. We have dummy brokerage data of these clients for 4 years. We will display this data on a dashboard in Power BI Desktop. First of all, let's import our data into the Power BI Desktop. In the Navigator window, we will select the transactions sheet and press Load. Wait for the data to load. Here, now we have all the fields to play with. Let's change the theme from View tab to Innovate. From the Insert tab, add a text box to your dashboard and enter a title for your report. Set the font size to 36 and make it bold. Now, place it at the top of the screen. Leave some space for a slicer. Add a slicer from Visuals. Place it at the top right corner of your report. From the Journal Ledger Date field, add the Year Hierarchy to the field area. Go to the Format Visual and change the slicer type to drop down. Properly place the slicer at the top right corner. We will change the background color of our report to black. We can also change the transparency of background color to our liking. Now add the country field to your dashboard. This will automatically add a map visual. Place it at the top left corner of the dashboard, below the title. Add the brokerage amount field to the bubble size area. Let's use the slicer to see if bubbles change or not. Looks like they are working. Rename the country field to country. Add a donut chart visual to your dashboard. Add the brokerage amount to the values field. Add the assured group to the legend area. Make a copy of this chart and place it below. Replace the assured group field with the reassured group field. Adjust the height and width of the visuals to keep them visually appealing. Add the customer type field to your dashboard. Change the visual to a bar chart. Add the brokerage amount field to the x-axis of the bar chart. Add a gauge visual to your dashboard. Place it below the year slicer, at the top right corner of the screen. Add the rate to brokerage field, to the value area of the gauge visual, and change it to average. Create a new measure, with zero value. Create another measure, with value of 0.06. Add the measure with zero value, to minimum value area, and the other measure, to maximum value area. Add the business name settlement field, to your dashboard. Place it at the bottom right corner of your screen. Change the visual to bar chart. Add the brokerage amount field, to the x-axis of your bar chart. Finally, add a line and column chart, to your dashboard. Add the brokerage amount field, to the column's y-axis. Add the gross amount, to the line y-axis. Add the client name field, to the column's legend area. Add the date hierarchy, to the x-axis, of the line and column chart, excluding quarters and days. If you want the client names to be visible at all times, change the position of legend to right or left of the chart, instead of top or bottom. We will place legend, at the center right of our visual. Our dashboard has been completed. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.